All right, so we just got back from the one pug life in Rutney. And Pants, what are you up to?
Oh, I'm taking off this makeshift mount here. And we got it welded all nice, so it won't break on us.
So this was the mount that Chris just made today for me, and I had to cut it because I had to have room for the nut and bolt there. So, yeah, that connects to the starter there. We'll just undo that and take her apart and weld her all. And I put that, put everything in place where it's going to be, like in regards to the bell housing, to make sure that everything is exactly where it's going to be. It's a lot easier with the bell housing off the transmission than on the transmission and trying to fight with it up down there. So hopefully this new oil pan will clear all this mess down here with the differential. I know it's going to be tight, but hopefully it'll clear it. I also got this, I think this is called the throwout bearing. So I took it all apart and cleaned it up. Well, it kind of needs some little bit more cleaning, but that bearing is the old bearing. We got that new kit there, so we'll put that bearing on there. Got this new heater all hooked up finally. Everything's all finished. Now this runs off a glycol hot water heater underneath my house, and that glycol heater or the hot water heater is filled up with glycol. That glycol is heated by the warm water from my geothermal. So finally got all of this finished up and wrapped up. A new pump came. It only took 3 weeks for it to come. It was covered under warranty. It was defective from warranty. It's got three speeds. It's got slow, medium, and high. So and circulate the fluid to however hot you want it. Got my redneck shop heat as an added boost, so I can get rid of my waste gas. Something else I've heard about is we get a lot of waste gas out of like the junk vehicles. So I was just wondering if it is possible to for stale gas to be used in diesel. Now, what do I have to do? What's all involved with that? And I'm kind of hesitant to trust the internet, but I think that's the only place I'm really going to learn anything about it. So, anyways, guys, leave a comment about it. And look at this. Brad. That was my good pair of underwear too. What? Oh, nice poop stain.
Oh, no. Those aren't your good pair anymore.
That's not my good pair anymore. No, that was all soiled from this. I think my wife threw this out because it had a hole in it or something. But yeah, got demoted to a shop rag.
Yeah.
Here, Brad, smell it. Smell it. Come on, Brad.
Freaks.
Are you a Dodge fan? You got your Dodge
hat.
Dodge hat
Dodge
on.
Neon.
That's what we got at the trade show, didn't we?
Oh yeah.
You're a big fan.
Big fan.
Big fan of the Dodge. Uh-oh.
This is
cold. Ooh. Well, bad news on the wire stripper. I don't know if we've done too much wire or a defective part. But, yeah, these two capacitors, take a big sniff of that. There, you can tell it smells a little funny. Anyways, yeah, it smells a little funny. Won't turn the motor over to turn the gearbox. That gearbox, there's nothing seizing it, but the motor won't turn it, so. Defective in the mail, coming tomorrow, hopefully. We'll get back to work.